The minority communities in India are known for their art and craft practices that are now subject to the forces of competitive markets and globalization. The lack of willingness amongst the younger generation of the craft communities to pursue or carry forward craft traditions is also a matter of utmost concern. In order to address these issues, the Ministry of Minority Affairs, Government of India, launched the scheme, Preserving Craft Heritage, along with enabling the minorities to avail opportunities in the growing market, are amongst the many objectives of the scheme.
The National Institute of Design has been a knowledge partner of the scheme since it was launched.
As knowledge partner, NID has contributed its knowledge, skills, and experience to achieve the established objectives under the scheme for the benefit of minority communities.
इसी लिहाज से कहते हैं कि कश्मीर में ऐसे हुनर है, ऐसे फन है जो पूरे दुनिया में किसी जगह नहीं है, जैसा कि पेपर मैश।
We'll try to push the boundaries of the craft and see where it can go, and also how can we utilize the skills these guys have and apply it in different fields so that they have multiple opportunities tomorrow and the craft has a bright future.
Benares used to be one of the most flourishing cities in terms of trade and pilgrimage. They used to have artisans' colony on the boundaries, on the periphery. And there were artisans belonging to both the communities, Hindu and Muslim. So there was no segregation and they were sharing a common platform. And that used to be the beauty of the culture of Benares, and that we call often Ganga Jamuni culture.
डिज़ाइन इनोवेशंस नहीं हुए या इस तरह की वर्कशॉप्स जैसे NID वर्कशॉप कर रहा है, तो ये इम्प्रूव करने के लिए बहुत ज़रूरी है कि इन क्राफ्ट्समैन को किसी तरह इनका अपग्रेडेशन हो किसी तरह, और नए क्राफ्ट्समैन तब आएंगे। हो सकता है फिर इनकी फैमिली के दूसरे लोग क्राफ्ट्समैन हो जाएंगे और ये लोग आगे बढ़ जाएंगे।
As an outcome of the three workshops, we were interested to have a good exhibition in Kochi. The idea of the exhibition was primarily to show to the interested stakeholders of this craft, which is the government sector, certain primary buyers, certain large craft chains, the possibility and the emergence of what we are talking of, the new generation of screw-pine craft products, and also to introduce them to these two organizations. The response that we got from most of the people who saw the products were amazing. They were really excited, and all they wanted to know is that how soon will these products be out for them to buy from the stands. That is something that is yet to be developed, because the development of these products is only the first big step. Now to price these products and have an entire production plan and a marketing plan for that is something that eventually the organizations will have to work out before we can see this new generation of stupan products out there in the market.
The ancient city of Firozabad is famous for its glassware industry, which employs a large number of skilled and semi-skilled laborers in and around the region. Glass industry history is 200 years old in Firozabad. It is said that the people who made and sold bangles were called Manihars. The glass industry, especially the modern glass bangles technology, was started and invented by Haji Rustam Ustad, Over time, production slowly became more widespread among the locals, and people from surrounding villages started pouring in, seeking for new opportunities. This was the start of the glass industry in Firozabad. Flame work is a type of glass work where a torch is primarily used to melt the glass. Once in a molten state, the glass is formed by blowing and shaping with tools and hand movements. It is also known as lamp working or torch working, even though the modern practice no longer uses oil-fueled lamps. In Firozabad, flame work is practiced by both the Hindu and the Muslim communities. The craft of bead and bangle making, practiced in several villages around Firozabad, laid the foundation of glass flame work, also known as Batti Ka Kaam.
All crafts have a certain aesthetic beauty to them, and even if they are similar materials, even if they are similar techniques, each person has their own artistic take to that. And art in any form is something that's worth preserving. That is what makes the world sane and livable.
The glass handicraft of flame work practiced in Firozabad has been going on for years. There is no denying that it has managed to spread and diversify, but at a very slow rate. Once we look at the craftsperson, their skill, the material, the technique, the product range, the market, etc. in totality, we can definitely say that there is a lot that can be done within the craft to increase exposure and market visibility. There is good possibility of extension of the product range in order to diversify both the product range as well as the market.
The village of Longpi is located in the hills of Manipur, where the Tangkul Naga men follow a pottery tradition that is deeply embedded in the tribe's history. The craft of black pottery has witnessed several waves of commercialization. Tangkul Naga potters make pots that not only serve domestic demands across northeastern states, but also for the urban lands across the country.
पत्थर होने के कारण उसको शेप नहीं टूटता है, शेप खराब नहीं होता है, कोल बनाए कोल रहेगी, तिरछा बनाए तिरछा रहेगा, ये पत्थर के ताकत से है। इस पत्थर से, इस मिट्टी से फायदा इसमें है कि इसमें कोई खाना पकाने से भी कोई चंग नहीं होता है, चंग नहीं होने के कारण हमको बीमार नहीं होता है।
A design intervention guided by an understanding of the craft community, their ecosystems and socio-cultural context was inspired.
Basically, it was a collaborative and a very participative approach, and we did organically took to that as well, and one can see that a lot of possibilities which were actually driven by the strength of the material. And it was really beautiful to see how the broken wares were used for flowering and for planting, you know, around their houses and around their residences. And that also became a very important aspect to our design intervention and product development.
The village of Nimalakunta, situated near Dharmavaram, the silk city of Andhra Pradesh, is known for the craft of leather puppetry. Traditionally known as Tolu Bommalata, where Tolu means leather and Bommalata means puppet dance, it began as a folk art used to make shadow puppets. It is believed that Tolu Bommalata is amongst the oldest shadow puppet traditions in the world.
Hello.
The craft of leather puppetry reached its peak during the reign of Krishnadevaraya of the Vijayanagar Empire, who ruled during the early 16th century.
We can take the reference of the oldest book of which was published from Banaras Hindu University, where they have talked about Shruti and Smriti, which is one of the oldest method in Veda. It is also mentioned in the Veda. That was the process through which our education process was going through. So Shruti and Smriti means, Shruti means listen and Smriti means remember. So the generation wise, this show was transferred from one generation to another generation. In the present scenario, now these epic shows are not that much important, and a lot of digital medias are here. So slowly, this heritage are diluting.
So our one task was making them to learn many more skills along with their own skill and come up with a new product. Earlier, for structural purpose, they were using metal. So in this workshop, maximum 90% the structural material what we used is bamboo. It is more sustainable and eco-friendly natural material than using a metal.
A range of new products such as storage boxes, lamp shades, wall installations, clocks, magazine racks, screen divider were developed during these workshops. Towards the end of the workshops, bamboo plantations were done to take a step towards making bamboo a part of the natural ecosystem of the village.
When you're adding a sustainable material to leather, it also add more value to the products. So that is what NID team had tried in Nirmalakonda.
The workshops gave a space for the community of puppeteers to be involved in a process of collaboration and co-creation with the NID design team. With these workshops, we saw a new spirit rise among the artisan community. We hope that this encourages them to nurture their ancient craft practice of Tolu Bommalata and take it to new heights.
राजस्थान में एक छोटा सा शहर है बीकानेर, और बीकानेर में क्या है कि एक कम्युनिटी रहती है, वो उस्ता है। उस्ता कम्युनिटी क्या है कि एक आर्ट के नाम से क्या है कि जानते हैं, जो क्या है कि एक उस्ता कम्युनिटी करती थी, जिसमें कुछ ट्रेडिशनल फूल और डिजाइन हैं जिनसे क्या है कि उस्ता कला को पहचाना जाता है कि ये उस्ता आर्ट है।
The Usta craftspersons reside in Ustoka Mohalla, which is a popular landmark in Bikaner.
सबसे पहले जो उस्ता लोग आए थे, उनका काम है जूनागढ़ किले के अंदर जो महाराजा राय सिंह जी का जो महल बना हुआ है, यानी चंद्र महल, तो उसमें चंद्रमा के जो रंग होते हैं, उसकी जो कलाएं हैं, वो सारी उसमें झलकाई है उस महल के अंदर। हम लोग इतने सौभाग्यशाली हैं के बीकानेर में लाल पत्थर की 1000 हवेलियां बनी हुई थी। 1000 हवेलियों का शहर बीकानेर, संसार में कहीं नहीं था।
Originally done on walls and ceilings, today Ustakala has adapted itself to various scales of work, ranging from ornamentations of interior spaces to miniature models and small-scale objects, to restoration of ancient monuments. Patronage has played a crucial role in supporting the craft throughout the years.
बहुत basic design concept है, जैसे हम form कहते हैं। तो form जो हम जैसे कोई shape देखते हैं, let's say मैंने एक त्रिकोण बनाया या मैंने एक circle बनाया, इसे हम shape कहते हैं, क्योंकि ये 2D है। मैं इसको कहीं से भी देख रही हूँ, चपटा ही रहेगा, मतलब उसको देख ही एक तरफ से रहेंगे, तो यहाँ से देखेंगे, यहाँ से देखेंगे, वो प्लेन है। जब कोई चीज़ तीन आयामी बन जाती है, तो उसे हम फॉर्म कहते हैं।
Artisans were also provided with a craft map, outlining the connections between these various vendors and a design tool that could serve as a guidebook to develop various product combinations.
So we approached the project with this idea of coming up with systemic objects. When we say systemic objects, objects that really emerge out of the context and are not force-fitted by an external agency or a trend or what's happening in international market. It's the context itself telling us what we should be making. It was sort of a jugalbandi between the designers and the artisans. It has never been a one-way street, and I think that's what is the most exciting part of the project also, where the base is being given by the designer and the ustad comes and then composes, and then we are having these conversations about narratives, and this is where the real potential of the craft unfolded for the entire team.
आज तक देखा जाएगा उसका कला सिर्फ दीवारों या फोटो फ्रेम इन पे होती नहीं, इससे भी अलग चीज़ों में कर सकते हैं और नई डिज़ाइन में नए कलर कॉम्बिनेशन के साथ भी हम उसका कर सकते हैं। ये इसका मोटिव है एनआईडी का कि आप अपने कला से थोड़ा बाहर निकल के दूसरी कला को भी कॉम्बिनेशन जोड़ के और इसको बाहर प्रदर्शन करें।
The craft of crochet is an integral part of Goa's material culture. Practiced by women across the state, the craft has taken on new forms in the contemporary market.
I think artisans of all age groups, they are open to experimentation, irrespective of their age groups. The ones which are slightly older, they are much well versed with the technique. They are able to work the yarn faster, but there's not much of a difference because it's an average age group that we are working with. And they all come with different set of skills, techniques. They all have a particular type of product category or a particular type of technique, such as Irish crochet or fillet work, that they have an expertise in. So they all carry these certain, skill sets which are unique to them.
After coming to this workshop, I have learned a lot. Like, I thought I could design a jewelry according to the taste of the customer. We have come to know a lot of things, how to market our product, how do we go about it? How much of labor, how do you take the product, the cost of the material, then the how much of time, the labor that goes in, and then your creativity, which we were never putting it into, we were never thinking about our creativity.
So let's not make like a huge thing about brands. You have your name, your brand name, and you sell under that brand name. You have good quality in your work. You have some, at regular interval, you provide some new things to your audience. Yeah, you experiment, and that itself is a good brand to start with.
The workshops introduce the artisans to a new range of techniques that were used to develop several products such as garments, lightings, home furnishings and decor, jewelry, bags, and many others. These experiences instilled a newfound creativity amongst the participants and became an enriching two-way exchange between the artisan and the design community.
सरकार ने ना दिता था ठटेरा उदा ठटियार कहने
जंड जमा आला जंडियाला ते गुरु इत्थे रहिंदे सी ओ गुरुआं दे नाल नाम मिल गया चलदा पिया जंडियाला गुरु
we visited the cluster for 10 days. Because Jandiala Guru has proximity to Amritsar, we also wanted to know the history of the place. Like, why of all the places did Jandiala Guru end up having this cluster? This is a project which is funded by Ministry of Minority Affairs, and our minority being the Sikhs of Punjab. When the partition happened, a lot of Muslim artisans sort of shifted to Pakistan in Kujrawala and Daska, and a lot of Hindu artisans shifted from Pakistan to India. So that exchange did happen, and if you see right now in the entire community, there's a mix of Hindu and Sikh artisans.
जब से metal का origin हुआ और metal age जिसको कहते हैं, तब से ही metal का काम चलता आ रहा है. और यहाँ जो है इसका origin महाराजा रंजीत सिंह के time से जो है इसको एक बढ़ावा मिला, क्योंकि उनका interest था. वो उन्होंने अलग-अलग जगह से craftsmen जो थे उनको लाया और उनको support किया. जंडियाला एज ए टाउन जो था इसका काफ़ी कंट्रीब्यूशन था इन ट्रेड, और पर्टिकुलरली विद रेफरेंस टू ये जो मेटल क्राफ्ट है, जो ठठेरा जिसको हम यहाँ बोलते हैं, तो इनके काम से काफ़ी इसका सिग्निफिकेंट रेफरेंस है, क्योंकि रेवेन्यू काफ़ी जनरेट होता था इससे.
जिसको मालूम है वो बर्तन कभी भी एल्युमिनियम का नहीं वाड़ता घर में, जिसको मालूम है. तो पहले जो कैदी होते थे ना, कैदी उसको ना सिल्वर का बर्तन देते थे, जिसकी उम्र 100 साल की थी ना, उसकी रियायत थी 70 साल की उम्र. आज के ज़माने में हम आप भी कैदी बन रखे हैं, आप ही अल्मोनियम वार रखी है घर में. वैसे जो पीतल है ना, पीतल में कली कराकर पकाना चाहिए, तो तांबे में पीना चाहिए, कांसे में खाना चाहिए. एक महीना खाकर देखो, आपको मालूम पड़ जाएगा कि क्या फर्क पड़ता है. साँस की बीमारी भी ना थोड़ी कम हो जाती है.
Our workshop had 16 to 17 locations, so that was our biggest challenge, because our design team had 4 people including me, and we had to deal with 24 artisans spread across 16 locations.
UNESCO ने इनको 2014 में एक इसकी जो है रिप्रेजेंटेशन मान ली. तो अभी ये लिस्टिंग है इसकी इंटेंजिबल कल्चरल हेरिटेज लिस्ट जो है यूनेस्को की, और ये इंडिया का फर्स्ट मेटल क्राफ्ट है जो उसमें है. अभी इनको ही यूनेस्को की रिकग्निशन इसलिए मिली है कि इन्होंने कन्वेंशनल वे में ही अपना काम जारी रखा है, पुश्त दर पुश्त काम जारी रखा है, हाथ से ही काम करवाते हैं, करते हैं, ये मशीन नहीं यूज हुई है.
एज मच एज वी नो, द एंटायर वर्ल्ड हैज अ फैसिनेशन फॉर ऑल द ट्रेडिशनल नॉलेज एंड विजडम दैट वी have in our India, so that can potentially lead to a huge demand in future.
So I think when you look in long term, the craft has a bright future if we systematically are able to create these revenue streams, if we are able to connect designers, if we are able to connect companies or organizations or even CSR activities and these artisans together in a bigger group. I think there's the potential of this craft becoming massive.
One more thing which the ministry or NID can do is making this craft much more accessible and visible to the community around it. If people from neighboring regions come and get exposed to how much effort that goes behind the craft, people will automatically become sensitive and connected to the practice, and there would be a lot of harmony between the cluster and the region. So for example, if there's a local museum which displays all these outcomes, there are installations or photographs which or videos which shows the process of the making, people will not judge these outcomes just by the look, but they would also be sensitive towards the effort which goes behind making it.
And at the same time, we also need to understand that this craft needs to have a geographical indication, because a lot of craft communities in India practice this metal craft, but Thatheras of Jandiala Guru are unique in the sense that they do everything by hand. It's entirely hand beaten, and this needs to be given preference using GI, because in the existing market, a lot of objects being made in Moradabad, which are actually casted or which are actually machine made, they are also sold in the e-commerce websites as handmade, made by Thatheras of Jandiala Guru. So we need to conserve and safeguard this craft if we want the future of this craft to be bright.
It is not the design development workshop from the initiation, because through craft research we found that this craft is dying and vanishing, so there is a need to revive this craft.
Procuring sand and preparing clay are the two most important processes in the craft. The product range developed includes jewelry, planters, lamps and tea lights, and traditional utility products for local consumption like diyas, incense pots, biscuit bowls and teacups.
Abhi yahan aake hame alag alag mitti banana naye technique se banana naye naye pots design naye shape naye design banane ko sikha, jaise market mein demand hai us hisab se kaise pot banana hai wo sab hame yahan sikhaya.
It's really amazing. It will have a lot of impact, not only on preservation of the craft, but also employment generation, income generation. This will give a lot of work for a lot of people in the village.
So while reviving this craft, we are trying to bring people together to build a community who will take this craft forward.
These workshops have introduced the craft practice to a new set of artisans, thereby taking a crucial step towards its revival. Younger artisans are also willing to innovate using new technologies and can be a link between the past and the future.